Kanhopatra. Kanhopatra is a female Hindu workery poet saint. Kanhopatra wrote Marathi Abhanga compositions which deal with the devotion to Vithoba, the patron deity of the workaries, and a struggle to balance this with her profession. Not much is known about the historical Kanhopatra's life. Much of the legends that deal with the life concentrate upon her death when she chose to surrender to Vithoba rather than become a concubine of the king of Bedar. Kanhopatra was a daughter of a courtesan named Shama, who lived in the town of Mangalveda. Kanhopatra was forced in the courtesan's life, though she detested it. Later, Kanhopatra withdrew from society and lived in Pandaripur, where the chief temple of Vithoba stands. She spent rest of her life singing and wrote Ovi-style poems as well as Abhanga poems dedicated to Vithoba. Upon hearing the tales of Kanhopatra's beauty, the king of Beda ordered her to be his concubine. When she refused, the king sent his men to get her by force. Kanhopatra took refuge in the Vithoba temple of the Pandarpur, the central shrine of god Vithoba. Kanhopatra died there. Kanhopatra merged with the central image of Vithoba in the form of marriage with him. Kanhopatra's last wishes. Her dead body was laid at the feet of Vithoba and then buried near the southern part of the temple. Here, a mysterious tree rose, which is worshipped by pilgrims today. Kanhopatra's Abhangas frequently portray her struggle between her profession and her devotion to God Vithoba, the patron deity of workaries. Only 30 of her Abhangas always survive today. 20 verses of her poems are included in the anthology of workari saints called Sakal Sant Gata. Kanhopatra speaks of her banishment from society owing to her family profession and social stature. She talks of thoughts of others. She feels that perhaps she was beyond scope of God's love. She acknowledges her God as the savior of the fallen and tells him to save her too. O Narayana, a name of God Vishnu, who is identified with Vithoba, you call yourself savior of the fallen. My caste is impure. I lack loving faith. My nature and actions are vile. Fallen Kanhopatra offers herself to her feet of a challenge to your claims of mercy. Now the full story. A village named Mangalpuram. The king took care of it very well. A lady born in Velalar Kulam named Shamala is a very good dancer. She is also very good in Sangeetam. She was very beautiful and she can sing songs which will make our hearts long for it. She dances in temples and also at the king's palace. She gets lots of prizes. This is her daily job. Shamala has a daughter named Kanhopatra. Whoever sees her will want to keep looking at her as she is very, very pretty. As a mother, she too was very good in singing and dancing. But she would not dance at the king's palace and only dance in front of Pandurangan, the lord of Pandaripuram. She always thinks of him and surrenders to him fully. Every day, morning, afternoon, evening and night, she is chanting his names. The residents of Mangalapuram celebrated Kanhopatra's dance song and also her love for Krishna. Like residents, the king too liked Kanhopatra a lot, but did not care of her love and bhakti for Krishna. He fell in love with her body. He wanted her at once as he would get crazy, so he asked the gods to give money and jewels and bring Kanhopatra to him. Shyamala was shocked to hear this. She knows her daughter is not like her. She only loves Krishna. She is not supposed to be born to her at all. She is always chanting Hare Krishna Pandarinada. Mother, if I marry, I will only marry like Andal to Krishna. He is my husband. No one else can take his place. She is like this. How will she agree to go to the king? She has given her heart to the Lord. Will she give her heart to the king? She won't. This king is a very rough person and he is a womanizer, fierce and bold. He will do what he wants. Now what should I do? How to tell this girl? What will she do? If we are born in this caste, this is the most difficult thing. Even if we surrender to the Lord, they still don't want to let go of this body. They wish to control all kinds of beauty. They want to make their slaves. If it was a different person, we can reject him easily. But he is the king. What to do? Her mother was very sad and suffered thinking a lot. Slowly, she talked to her daughter. Her daughter shut her mouth. Mom, what are you asking? Even when you know about me, I have surrendered to God's lotus feet. I will only serve him by dancing and singing in the temple. I won't obey even if he is a king. Please return the money, gifts and jewels to the king. I will not become slave to the things that can be destroyed. Only my Kannan, Parthan, Pandurangan can give me orders, and I will obey him only, even if he is the king or has all the wealth in this world, or has conquered the entire earth. He can't get me. I am only related to the Lord, mother. Her mom was surprised and unbelieving to hear this. She found her daughter was very serious and was happy. I am happy, my child. I am proud to have given birth to you. Our thinking that we are slaves will change with someone like you, who has a strong mind and brave. It is all because of your love for God. Kanhopatra fell at her mother's feet and cried, Mom, bless me. Like Anda, I too want to join with Pundarikachan. Please bless me, Mom. The mother hugged her close and said, Get going, child. Do not waste here even a second. There's a bhajan group going to Pandaripuram. Go with them, child. I will take care of the king. Hurry up and go now. The next minute, Kanhopatra went to Pandaripuram with the bhajan group. She had a tambura in her hands. She sang and walked to Pandaripuram with the bhajan group. She reached, and when her feet touched Pandaripuram soil, her heart was thrilled. How are you, Pandarinatha? Panduranga, Vitala, please join me with you, O Lord. As you did with Andal, as with Mira, take me too with you, my Lord. Take this poor girl with you. Don't let her, your slave, be here. I surrender to you, Gopala. She kept on saying this emotionally. She had a bath in Bhima River. After bath, she came to temple. Each step she took, she raised her hands and sang sweetly with a lovely voice. Some places she called, Hey Murali, Hey Mohana, and danced too. Once she entered the temple, she prayed to Vitalan and kept staring at him without blinking. Hey Prabhu, when are you going to take me with you? Will you not take me? She fainted and fell to the ground. When she was at Pandaripuram and praying, the king was waiting for her eagerly, thinking of her only. Why is it taking so many for the guards to come back and no answer to? He lost patience and he called his servants and asked them to check at her home. The servants returned and informed the king that Kanhopatra has gone to Pandaripuram. She only thinks of Pundarikachan and no one else in her heart. Who is Pundarikachan? Bring him to me. I will sentence him to be hanged, the king said angrily. The guards were shocked and said, Dear Lord, Pundarikachan is not a human being. He is God. He resides in the temple of Pandurangan, a place called Pandaripuram. He is Sri Krishna. When he heard that, the king, even when angry, started laughing loudly. What are you saying? Love with God? And that too with Pandaripuram, Pandurangan, Sri Krishna, Paramatma, her human girl, born in Kulam. She thinks she is too pretty. She can imagine anything. This is very crazy, mad. Maybe she went to escape from me. She did this on purpose. It could be to reject me. She is really crazy, he thought. Guards, go to Pandaripuram, wherever she is. Find her and bring her here. Tell her this is my order. If she would not come, tie her and bring her to me, he ordered. The guards and soldiers took the horses and went for Pandaripuram. When they reached there, Kanhopatra was with devotion in bhajan. She forgot herself and was singing the bhajan. Bhajan ended. Prasadam was given. Kanhopatra took the prasadam and went outside. The guards surrounded her. She was shocked and scared and looked at them. Mother, Mangalpuram king asked us to bring you at once. He has sent the carriage for you. Mother, let's go now. Once she heard this, Kanhopatra started to cry and raised her hands and said, You call me mother. After calling me mother, can you do this to me? If it was your mother, would you take her to the king? The guards and officers were shocked and did not know what to do. She ran to the Lord. Her eyes filled with tears. She prayed to Lord Krishna. Panduranga, won't you save this poor lady? Can't you be kind to me?
Seeing her cry, the priests were crying too. They too joined in prayers to save the lady. When the guards and officers were not sure what to do, a miracle happened. The miracle came from the shrine. A bright light like sunshine came from inside. Bells started ringing. The sangha was blown loudly. Vedam Paranam was started. The jyoti came from Pandarinathan eyes at the opposite with raised hands to Kanhopatra, full of tears. The jyoti surrounded her. The next minute she disappeared. The Lord came as jyoti form, took Kanhopatra with him. This was realized by the priests and they said loudly, "Hey Pandarinatha, Panduranga," and raised their hands over their heads and did namaskaram till fell to the ground and started to pray. Later they informed the guards and officers that the king that Pandurangan has taken his devotee with him. They buried her body in the south part of the temple. After they buried, the place was very bright with light. At once there grew a tree with leaves and flowers. It was very, very nice and very pretty. The people, on seeing this, started talking about Kanhopatra and the divine soul she had for Pandarinatha. But the king did not believe this. He went to Pandaripuram with his minister, wanting to check. He went straight to the tree where the body was buried. The crowd there was full. The devotees were lighting lamps and were surrounding the trees and praying to the tree. Some were doing namaskarams. He realized that Kanhopatra has actually become a god to be prayed and respected. He understood that Lord Pandurangan had joined her soul with him. At once he too went around the tree and fell at the ground, did namaskaram. He got up with tears in his eyes and asked for her forgiveness. People, finding the king has changed, and the priests were very happy. The king turned to the tree and prayed, saying, "Mother, my mother, God, please forgive me. I have given you lots of trouble. Please, without knowing about your pure heart, please forgive me, mother. From today, my country and my people all are Pandurangan slaves. All the people here will pray to you." The people, after hearing this, they raised their hands and started clapping and were happy to see the king. "If you go now to Pandaripuram, you still can see the tree and people surrounding it happily and peacefully." The end.